I'm fucked up.
That Gary, bro.
Let me touch that.
You get carried away sometimes.
No, I love it. That's how you know it's good. He was blowing on that motherfucker, bro.
It is good, isn't it?
I'm gonna leave the rest of this with you then.
It's some ancient herb essence.
This
going
some, this
on
some
in
funk.
Shit.
Like the shit we smoked at first was like an appetizer. Tastes really, really good.
Yeah.
We're high.
Yes, we are.
We high as giraffe pussy, nigga. Are we gonna do some rolling?
Yeah, I'm gonna roll up this one first. You
what's
got
in
this
here, brother?
I said Gary Payton.
Oh. Ooh, Gary Payton.
Let's try Gary.
Yeah,
love
Gary.
Gary.
We're gonna do that one next. This one, I remember he likes sativa, so I wanna roll this one up.
Yeah, sativa's my thing.
Smell this right here, big bro. I've been saving this bud. I had to fight everyone off that bag because I knew I was going to see
it. That was beautiful.
That's the London pound cake. Can I hear
it's actually
that?
The London pound cake with the limoncello. I just needed this bag. But that shit right there, like.
It's beautiful.
Oh, it's beautiful.
That shit tastes so fucking good. We need that first. We need to spoil our lung with
smoke.
That.
You got blunt paper. What kind
smells
of paper
like jelly.
Yeah, it's like a blueberry jelly, huh?
Yeah.
Got some vibes in the building, some vibe papers.
So what we doing, dude? I'm ready paper. To go.
All right, let's do this shit, brother. Everybody's ready. Mike, you want me to bring us in?
Yeah.
Dude, dope hat.
Yeah, it's young guy out there gave this to me, man.
It's awesome. Hey, everybody. Welcome to another episode of Hotboxin. I'm Eben Britton.
And I am Mike Tyson.
And Mike, we got a great guest here today.
Oh, man. Let's bring him in.
Let's go. We got the man, the myth, Berner.
Kaiser Soze, young Berner.
Yes, sir. I love
so
that.
Up,
Usual
what
suspects,
what you got
baby.
What's going on, Berner?
Man, you know, I've just been grinding, big bro. Just knocked out this album of Currency. We recorded it in 3 days. Fire. A lot of doobies.
Wow.
A lot of classic records.
3 days, man.
3 days. I just dropped El Chivo, the album. That shit went crazy. I charted really well. Just having fun with it, man. You know,
is 3 days typical for a recording session, or was that
kind of
inspiration?
You know, for me, I feel like this, like when you hustle like this, because I got, you know, we'll get into it later, but I got a lot of shit going on. So I go crazy for about, you know, a couple weeks, a month, and you lock in for 3 days and all you focus on is that music, and you know that your time is money, and you know that you're spending money on that studio. I get it cracking. I can't do a whole album through a year and just relax. Nah. Like, I'm about this bag right now.
I used to watch them, and they be in there for months.
Yeah, for months.
You know what I mean?
Some people
they be in there for a year.
Yeah, some people be, like, really overthinking the process.
Yeah.
For me,
yeah.
It's like, yo, you know, it's almost like therapy, really, though.
Oh, for sure, because you're probably getting out a lot of emotions, a lot of energy that you've had stored up.
As you guys know, the Weed Game's crazy, man.
Yeah, absolutely.
Weed Game's crazy.
And you've been in it for a while.
Almost, 18 years.
Which one's selling the most? Gary Payton sells well?
You know what? Gary Payton's popping right now. It's one of our most popular. Yeah, I mean, first of all, I think he's one of the first guys, you know, as a ball player to go in a bag like a Wheaties box. Like, that's really Gary. You know what I mean? And
always love Gary.
And the pack speaks for itself, too. Like,
yeah.
You smell this motherfucker. It's just so loud. It's so different. It's a nice cross. He got himself.
Oh, this is really
good.
Yeah,
he got himself a hell of a cross. For
let me try that.
This is really good.
It's like it's different than the one we're about to smoke now. The one we're gonna smoke now is like real, like player kind of tropical vibe.
I can dig it.
How long has Gary been in the weed game?
You know what? Our relationship happened really randomly. We were on the internet, and we nicknamed it Gary Payton because it was Pheno number 20, and we were kind of on the internet calling it that. And he hit me up through some, you know, really reputable people I know. You know what I mean? And he was like, he want to sit with you. I'm like, oh, shit. And he pulled up in the white Range Rover, man, just like a gangster, bro, and pulled up. And in Oakland, we had some lunch, and we really caught a vibe. And I'm like, bro, like, we could really pop this off on the legal market because we all like it. And he was down. So, you know, from my understanding, he
really
just got
cool.
in.
That's dope. Yeah. I mean, it's a great name. It's such a good name.
It's the glove, baby.
It says so much.
Yeah, no, it's powerful, dude.
I love that.
It's good. It's cool, too, because a lot of ball players smoke, man. And so shout out to Matt Barnes and all the boys out there advocating for them to be able to use this.
You got
to
smoke. Look, it's the highest form of fucking thinking, you
man,
know?
Man, it opens
high.
Up the mind. It helps your body.
You know?
Like
that's why we call it high, I figured it. That's why we say it's high, because it's the highest form of thinking.
For sure. Exactly. Yeah, no, this shit opens the creativity.
Absolutely.
You know what I mean? That's how you knock an album out in 3 days, though, is all the different weed. All this shit will make you feel different. You know what I mean? So that shit just get your little heart beating, get your mind running, and you're going to go in there and go crazy.
What are those two strains?
So these are brand new. It's orange push pop times wedding cake F3. So they're different. Wow. Go ahead and put your nose on
which
that.
One is this?
That's the orange push pop with the wedding cake F3. They're both the same cross, just different numbers. So number four and number nine.
That's good.
Oh, shit's fire.
Love like potion number nine, dude.
That shit number nine is fire.
I believe it.
Number nine is fire. Me and B-Real were smoking that last night. And that's one of our favorites right there, that number nine.
We love B.
He's the best.
We were just in the car, hotboxing with him in the car.
Oh, man. I did that thing a bunch of times. That you have to learn how to survive
in there.
Smoke
that. Let's check
that
out.
Yeah, fire that up, big bro.
Let's check this out.
Weedmaps is your guide to cannabis. We're how you find savings, learn more about the plant, and catch up on the latest cannabis news. We've been connecting cannabis consumers and medical patients to local cannabis retailers and brands since 2008. Visit weedmaps.com to join the largest cannabis tech community on the planet and search cannabis in your local area. Weedmaps. Learn about, find, and enjoy cannabis smartly.
Get a hold of you. You guys got a beautiful building here.
Thanks, brother. Yeah, we love it. We have a good vibes in here. Great people. Good flavor.
Blueberry, lemon, cherry real quick.
Ooh, I love that.
Yeah, that's just fire right there.
Yo, how do you get the taste like that?
You know, it's just all, like, that's a four-way cross, right? So, lemoncello, that's lemonade and cherry pie. We cross that first. Lemonade and cherry pie should, you know, you kind of get what flavors are coming. Then we hit it with the London pound cake, which is cookies, sherbet, tangy, and OG. It's a four-way cross. So really just, these breeders, man, they just got a lot of passion. Let's just put it like
there's
that.
There's some wizards, man.
Yeah, they could be lazy and grow OG and just sell OG all day, but
yeah.
We really care about that flavor. You know what I mean? I think when I met you first in Vegas, I gave you some of that lemonade.
Yeah, every time somebody say they got weed, let me smoke it.
Yeah.
Let me try it.
Yeah, you got to sample it.
People always say, Mike, I'm in the business of the most yanny on you.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
You got to sample it.
Yeah, nah, but you know, it's a craft to get, we like to spoil the flavor, you know, the taste buds,
yeah,
it's man.
Really good.
Yeah.
No, that shit's nice right here.
How long has Cookies been around?
You know,
you've been out for a minute, though.
We've been out for a minute, bro. I want to say, like,
you got 10 years
at least 10 years. Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah, at least 10 years.
Wow.
Damn, see, I didn't even know that.
Yeah. It's been a while. I'd be forgetting. I mean, I remember I put the video out with when I was rocking Cookies for the first time, like in 2009, I think.
Wow.
So at least 10 years, and it was around before that. So, yeah, 10, 12 years, probably.
I remember Cookies.
Yeah, we did a good job with it, man. Like, the branding of it, like, besides it just being a strain, like, the actual brand and the colorway and, you know, this blue, we own, you know, we feel like we own this colorway blue. And
it looks good, too.
You know,
yeah,
the
it
identity,
looks great.
You know,
it's great packaging.
And, but the color's just very alluring. You fucking with it. That's nice.
And then if you feel it, like, feel it. It's hella soft.
Yeah. It is.
Well, you know what comes across to me
like
is that there's a lot of love for the plant and the company.
I'm obsessed.
Yeah.
I've been obsessed with weed since I was a kid, and I've dedicated my whole life to this shit. And we trip out sometimes because now it's such a big business.
Right.
And, you know, my job being, I got like 30 jars like this at the house. I have to go through and I have to find and pick what I like and name and create an identity, a logo. And that's my job. I fucking love my life. This shit's amazing.
That's what we say when we come here. I can't believe this is what I got to do.
Man, it's just, we're blessed to be in the position to be able to, one, curate beautiful menus, but two, to influence what people are actually smoking out there.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Because I really want this shit, when it goes around the world, to be just like what we're smoking right now.
Yeah.
There's a lot of foo-foo out there. And motherfuckers that don't care about it, don't give a fuck what people are going to grow in Arkansas. Mm-mm. Places that never were able to experience cannabis like this, I want them to taste this shit.
Yeah.
That's our mission.
Can I try a taste of that?
Please, bro. Please.
When did you get into music? How did... Because you've... I feel like, you know, you... We can... I'd love to hear the whole story, but I feel like you've come up with your music, your cannabis business, entrepreneurship has sort of come right with that.
You know, to be an open book, bro, I've always been a fan of music before I made it. And when I first started making it when I was younger, I had a little extra money to play with because I was doing my thing. Like a lot of other artists that came up, I was hustling. I wanted to do something with my bread. And just by being a fan of it, I picked good beats. I got good album covers. I got good features. I did group albums. And I kind of learned how to be an artist the right way just by being a fan of it. So I think when you do something out of passion, you're going to win. You know what I mean? So the music, I just stay consistent. I got about 34 albums out, and I'm independent as can be. And
that's amazing work,
got about
man.
20 Billboard plaques, and, you know, just my shit pops, bro, as an independent artist. And I think just the passion and the work ethic is what gets it cracking. Mm. And I learn every album. You know, like every time I do a new album, it's a new experience. I get it. It's like practice. You know, it's like going to the gym for the mind, really. That's what I feel like.
Was there anything really interesting about this latest experience with Currency that you've already sort of downloaded?
Currency, new artist, right?
Yeah, man. No, Currency, he's been out for a while.
He's been around a while.
He's been around for a while. You know what I liked about it was that we've known each other for a long time. We've done records before, and everyone's always asked.
So nice, dude.
Like, oh, it's beautiful, right?
It's beautiful.
People always ask, what's up with the group project? And so being able to do it was dope. When you jump in there with another artist, you feed off their energy. So I'm looking at him like, this Currency, he can rap. He's looking at me like, this Burn, he does his thing, he can rap. So you start getting that energy where it's like a friendly, competitive kind of vibe. And it just makes everything come out better.
Who'd you like working
with? That's cool.
Man, I love to work with DJ Quick. When I worked with him, it was amazing.
Love DJ Quick.
You know, he came
Quick.
In and he set up everything on the spot, the MPC that made all the big records, and we made an amazing record, so shout out to DJ Quick. And then most recently, I did a Latin crossover record. I don't speak Spanish, but I did a record with this group, and they spoke Spanish. I spoke English. It's called El Chivo.
Yeah.
And that shit blew up, like, globally, and it's doing really well right now. That was cool because it was all live instrument.
What's the name of the song?
That's dope,
It's called El Chivo.
That's the album?
That's the name of the album and the title song.
Dope.
But you got the video out yet?
Yeah.
The video?
Yeah.
Put that shit up, dude.
Yeah. Nah, it's cool, too, because, like, bro, the live instrument shit is so vibey when you're getting high and motherfuckers playing, like,
yeah, that's dope.
The bass and the guitar. The like, it's like, I feel like I'm in a fucking band. I like that shit, bro. I'm like, man.
We're high. I'm going to check this shit out.
Oh, yeah. It just hit 10 million views in less than a month, too.
Yeah.
El Chivo, bro. First thing when you put that L in, you seen that,
yeah.
Huh?
You came seen right that out good.
Right when
Chivimo.
You put
Chivimo. Let's see what he's talking about. Okay, let's check this out.
Here we go, El Chivo.
I never seen it on a big screen like this.
Big ass screen, dog.
And we're in the studio, money. Oh, yeah.
It's got to be fun to do a video like this.
This is a totally different video than I usually do. I usually do real street like style videos, and this shit was like, you know, they have a bigger platform than I have.
Yeah, nigga. Player.
Dope, dude.
Oh,
watching the beat drop.
Oh, you look at you mean girl.
He's looking at me,
mean mugging him.
My acting debut, bro.
I love that, bro. Where was this at? Where'd you do this shoot?
Kind of by the Grapevine out here.
Oh,
on the way back to the Bay Area if you're leaving LA.
Up the 5.
And this kid right here, shout out to Chris. He's a star, man. He's popping. Yeah. They're selling out arenas on their own, bro. It's like, this was a big collaboration right here.
That's dope.
And they watch how the beat flip, though.
Burner!
Oh, the whole vibe of the bar shifted.
Exactly. So this is the first time someone's really did this in, like, the urban Latin music. Like, no one's done this yet. We're the first one to flip it like this.
I love it, man.
And it popped. It's a fresh new sound. Like, people's like, okay. And then it goes back big wise.
That looks good, man. You got the bros up there.
It looks dope. And do you work into all of your deals, your video deals, that Cookies get some screen time?
You know what the best thing about this shit is, bro? I'm going to keep it real. This shit's so good, I don't have to pay nobody nothing, bro. Mm. They want to have this shit around.
Yeah, yeah.
You know what I mean? Like,
really, you want your weed out on camera?
It's like, you guys want to smoke some good bud? Then cool. But nah, it's all organic, man. Everything we do is organic.
Yeah, that's awesome, dude.
Organic love.
Well, Cookies and T-Ranch have a little collaboration
man,
going on.
Man, we do.
On.
And I seen the product yesterday
yeah.
in the store. I seen it in the store. I'm not sure if they dropped it yet, but I seen it in the safe because I'm like a weed cop when I go in there. I want to see everything that's going on. I want to see what we got. And that shit's fire.
Cookies has
our
a store.
Our intention is to take over the world with our weed.
Oh, that's what we're going to do. We got the megaphone, Mike.
Yes.
You know what I mean? Yeah, nah, Cookies is a store. We got one in Melrose on Melrose Ave. And we got one in Maywood, which is kind of by downtown LA, for those that don't know. And Dr. Green Thumb, which is B-Real as well. got it in there, which is our, you know, our close family, you know, mafia.
Love it.
And
all day, every day.
Yeah, I think it's gonna be big. It's over.
Oh yeah, man.
You know,
what's your favorite part of the cannabis industry?
I like,
because you guys grow, you do concentrates.
Everything, from everything from seed to sale. My favorite part of the business in general is knowing that I'm providing shit that is smokable, that's good.
Yeah.
Like I like knowing that, like, I really go through all this and I design these designs and I pick these phenos and I name them, and more importantly, I know that when we do a deal in Arizona, the good people of Arizona are gonna smoke fire. When we do a deal in Chicago, where they really need this out there, this good vibe, we're gonna bring that good out there. I like knowing that when we come, it's like a breath of fresh air almost, because we really love this shit.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Yeah, we're very high.
You guys were here, you guys were in here blowing down big before I got here.
Yeah.
I seen it. I was watching.
We just keep it flowing.
We stay high.
We keep it flowing.
Very high.
It gets meditative, you know.
Well, you guys got a mellow ass spot with really comfortable furniture, and everyone gets high. So before we came in here, I was out there blowing it down with everyone too. So
yeah. And that's nice, right?
Yeah.
It's a nice vibe when you can just do that. Everybody's chill. And you know what the thing is? I always think this is fascinating, but of course. It's like, you can be in here, everybody in the building could be smoking a joint, blowing smoke in the air, and it's still, the air is super breathable. If that was everybody in the building smoking a cigarette,
you'd be fucked up.
You'd have a fucking headache. You couldn't even be in the building.
I'd be like, you swallowed a dry fucking piece of bread.
Isn't that interesting?
Yeah.
So when people try to tell me the, oh, well, you know, you're endorsing smoking, because I played in the NFL, you know, and I was like, and I'm like, well, you have no fucking clue that this is completely different than
a
cigarette.
You're endorsing good vibe, and you're endorsing, like, you know, positivity. Yeah.
Positivity.
Yeah. Exactly. Game changing. Has anyone on the show brought you guys some boof-ass weed yet? I know everyone comes bearing gifts and stuff. You don't have to say their name. I'm just curious.
Like, anybody brings this stuff when they come in? Most of the time, right? What do you think?
Yeah, we always get
anything. Like, any treats. Bullshit? Is people out here
anybody
smoking bullshit?
Pretty cool, I think.
Everything's decent. You know when it's next level, though. For me, like, I know when it's really next level. Like, this weed is next level.
Yeah.
Like, it's a different vibration.
Mm.
You know. Some weed, you smoke it, and right away you just feel a little bit off.
Mm.
We want cannabis cups and shit, so you know our ego is fucking soaring.
Yeah, you feeling it right now.
Yeah, we're stoked, man.
You're like, don't bring the mic, no bullshit, please.
Yeah, yeah. So, but yeah, man, you know how it is.
Yeah.
You know, there's a lot of pranksters out there. There's a lot of fucking people doing it half-assed or just for the money.
There's a lot of people growing just for yield. Like, this shit, this is a really hard plant to grow. This weed doesn't grow like big and fat and chunky. It's a pain in the ass, but it tastes great.
Yeah. And the more you put into it, the more you're going to get out of it.
I agree 100%.
You know.
You got to love it.
Well, there's going to be like some sort of cookies tent at the Tyson Ranch in Desert Hot Springs.
Please, come on. Yeah, I want to throw a dope ass little like taste test out there when we get a new strain or something.
Hell yeah, dude!
You know, let everyone come taste it.
We're off the hook, man.
Little private little
event.
Nobody's
ever gonna see anything like
it. Nah. Especially with us. We're gonna roll some of this Gary Payton.
Love
this motherfucker right here, just
check Gary out. Ooh.
How you feel, Mike?
I'm high as cow, fucking giraffe ass, right?
What's your favorite weed to smoke right now, Mike?
What is this shit? Sour diesel.
You love that sour.
I can't stop it.
I remember we got some for you in Vegas, too. That's what you wanted, that sour. That sour is good. I mean, if you get the right
sour.
Sour
Dees.
Yeah.
I love Jack Herrera.
Jack, you like that good
just
sativa,
always,
yeah. Oh, you know what? I brought you some, brother. I remember you like sativas.
Oh, so nice of you.
This right here is called Melanata. It's one of our brands that we acquired and partnered with from Grand Flora, but that's that good sativa right there, brother.
Roll something up.
Hell, that's my boy right here. That's my boy right here.
That's what we do here, man.
I've been waiting to smoke with you, man, for real, because I met you in Vegas. We weren't able to blaze there, so.
What year was that?
Do you want to use
probably
this,
three or
Burn?
4 years ago. Yeah. I got it. I'll just trap it out on here.
All right, you sure?
Yeah.
All right.
We went in the grow, remember? We went into the grow. You was checking out some buds.
In Vegas?
And I'll never forget, there was a big old bud, like a big old cola, and Mike walked up to that motherfucker and just squeezed the shit out of it. Smelt it. And then when he walked away, that bitch was still kind of crinkled up like a Capri Sun can. And then I was like, damn, blood, Mike just crushed that nug. but it bounced back, and we actually smoked that motherfucker, bro. I kept track of which planet. Yeah, because he walked up to it, and he was like,
That had some mic acid.
Damn, my boy crushed that motherfucker. And we kept track of it. I put a little ribbon around it. And when we harvested, I smoked that bud, bro.
How was it? Did it hit
fire.
Hard?
It was fire.
Of course.
I'm a little heavy-handed sometimes.
Hey, it knocked me out. Right. It knocked me out. No pun intended.
That's so funny.
Killing myself down here. Those are the screams I used to make when I would cut myself, of course. Shaving before I knew about Manscaped. You need to try this out for yourself, you know. The Manscaped Lawn, man, it's the best mower. 3.0 has been beautifully designed to reduce those painful nicks and tugs. I get 20% off free shipping with the code HOTBOXIN at manscaped.com. 20% off with free shipping at manscaped.com. And use the code word HOTBOXIN and always use the right tool for the right job.
Okay, I'm gonna go shave now. Take care.
All right. Yeah. Oh, baby. Yes, suck it to me.
That's so funny. Are you from the Bay?
I'm from San Francisco, California.
Wow.
Yeah.
I love it, dude. Where do you live?
What's that like? That seems so cool over here.
You know, the Bay Area is different than LA in the sense that, like, man, there's just hustlers out there, bro. Motherfuckers out there hustling. And
yeah.
It's not so fast-paced, like, business-wise in the Bay. It's just hard to explain. When I come to LA, I'm just boom, 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 boom. When I get back to the Bay, I just be around the players and the hustlers. Man, I love the Bay Area.
Yeah. But, Mike, you'll appreciate this because you said this when you got back from San Francisco, but I felt like it was very East Coast.
Oh, it feels like, well, listen.
It's got a very East Coast vibe, Brooklyn vibe.
I'm moving there. Yeah. I love that place.
Man, the Bay Area is nice, bro.
I know a thing. I just can't fucking take those fucking high fucking slanted ass fucking
roads. Oh, the hills?
Yeah, the roads.
Yeah, yeah.
What's the deal with that?
Walking the roads were insane.
It's just a little much, man. I try to avoid those streets. Since I'm born and raised, I know exactly what street not to mob up, but you know, when you're high and you're smoking with your boys and your car
you
pulls up like
that.
This,
yes.
And then
the car is almost vertical.
You're like,
you
bro.
Know when you have the clutch and you got to be right on time or you're going to go back.
That
you're like, man.
Gonna go back.
You start hitting cars, boom, 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 boom. I said, I'm fucking sorry.
Yeah, man, I don't like that stop, bro. Especially when you're hotboxing with a weirdo that's driving and the motherfucker's looking at you like, you're like, dude, look, get over this fucking hill.
Yeah.
We're parked like this.
Yeah.
This car is full of smoke.
It's insane.
Yeah. We've gotten pulled over on one of them crazy hills, man.
Oh, my God.
Yeah,
you're just sitting there like this.
Yeah, you're sitting there smoking, and it's fucked up. Yeah, the Bay Area is good, though, man. Mike, you gotta come
I love the Bay Area.
I've been out to the Bay Area a couple of times.
Yeah, man.
Bay Area, another stronghold of talent and a lot of creative thinking.
Yeah, shout out to E40, man.
Oh, definitely.
Dude, bro, a lot of motherfuckers come out the Bay.
Definitely.
We've been
too short.
Too short, man. Of course. Rest in peace, Mac Dre. Rest in peace to the Jacka. The Bay Area got a big influence on music too, man. Like,
absolutely.
On the independent
got
music.
Got five on it, motherfucker.
Man, come on, man. Mike knows what's up. The
well,
Bay.
Shit, man. The Bay was the birthplace of the counterculture.
Yeah.
Yeah, they started throwing down.
You know.
Huey Newton and all those guys.
Yeah, nah. It's always been real, like, just next level when it comes to like politics and, you know.
Yeah, just very
free spirits,
very forward thinking, progressive minded.
Motherfuckers laying in front of buses back in the days in the Bay when they were protesting and shit. They're about it.
You know what's interesting too is the areas with the highest levels of consciousness, say San Francisco,
absolutely,
are the people doing the most drugs.
Yeah.
Is that interesting?
I've done a lot of drugs, bro.
The most psychedelics, smoking the most weed, the most things happening like that. Isn't that interesting?
We were talking about the toad out there before I came in. And,
have you done the toad?
I have.
Wow.
Yeah.
Amazing, man.
I did it at Reggae in the River. That shit was
Tell
crazy.
Tell me about that. You should stay away from the fucking river when you're in the toad.
Yeah.
Man, look, bro,
you
listen.
You might drown.
You had people
My boy tried to box me. My boy tried to box me. He didn't really tell me what I was going to feel like. I did a lot of acid prior to trying this.
Yeah. Mm.
And I had bad trips on acid, so I wasn't really feeling that
me
kind
too.
Of vibe anymore. You know what I mean? And so when I hit the toad, I hit it. And when I blew it out, I felt like my whole fucking body jumped
That's
out my mouth.
Me.
And I was like this, like just tripping like just tripped out. My boy put his hands up, was trying to swing on me. He's like, bro, I thought you were gonna attack me. I'm like, motherfucker, I was lost. I was gone. I was just feeling, it felt like Lord of the Rings when he put the ring on and take the ring off. Like it just was like whole outer body experience.
Wow.
And it lasted for like 15, 20 minutes and then went away. And then I hit it one more time because I was like, wow. And then I ran away from the RV and I came back, just tripped out. So Reggae in the River is definitely a crazy experience up there.
What's Reggae in the River?
Yeah, what the fuck is that?
I mean, that's an event. That's an event in Northern California where we used to go sell a bunch of bud at, sell drugs at. But it's like a festival, a 3-day festival. You sleep outside, you camp outside. You used to go up there, fuck bitches, smoke big, make money, eat food, camp, and it was just nonstop music for 3 days. Wow. It was cracking. And it's in Humboldt County, so if you know about, you know what's up. It was big.
Yeah.
It's super big. It was tight, man.
That's dope.
What makes you happy, man?
My daughter.
Yeah.
My daughter.
How old is she?
How old?
She's 11.
Oh, mine's 10. I have a 10-year-old.
You know, when you work like this, bro, the kids keep you happy, man. And I just got a couple Labradors, too, that keep me happy, too. Dogs are the shit.
Yeah, dogs are amazing.
You know, so.
I have two.
The house makes me happy because I'm really there too much. Moving around a lot.
Yeah. I find as I get older, my life literally becomes about creating as much good shit as I can and reaching as high as I can in my professional life and then my family.
Yeah, you got to do what you want to do at this point in life, man. Yeah. And the goal is now, and what I've been working towards, is to work with who I want to work with, not who I have to work with.
Mm.
So I want to be here right now with y'all. This is legendary shit.
Thank you.
And
thank
I'm here.
You,
so it feels good to
happy
be able
you're
to,
here, too.
It feels good to be able to do that kind of shit because I could have to be somewhere else.
Right.
You know, working. Yeah. And so to be able to do this as my career is fucking blessing.
On that point, would you say there are times in your life where you have been in that situation where you have to be at that place where you have to be?
Absolutely.
Yeah, rather than where you want to
get in that studio, motherfucker. Else we ain't getting no money.
Hey, them grow houses that you know I used to have to be in when it was not legal. That we are, you know, putting money up, putting our names on the
never
on
know
the
who's
leases.
Gonna come in that day, huh?
Yeah, you might get robbed. You might get raided, bro. That should be really like you know PTSD from that shit, bro.
Yeah, I think that's an important thing you just hit on that highlighted for me was getting to that place in your life where you can be exactly where you want to be.
Where you
want to
be.
You have to go through those times where you got to be
and
where you got to be.
Times build courage.
Yeah.
And reach. You know, I had the most fun last week. I went to Maui with my girl just to go chill for 5 days. And I just laid on the beach and read about aliens for 5 days. I got high as fuck.
Dude, let's talk about
aliens.
And
I read about aliens for 5 days, and I'm woke. I'm fucking woke. I know what's up. They're not lying to me no more.
What do you think about that?
Yeah, tell us,
look,
bro.
I mean, I don't want people to think I'm nuts, but I really think that we are a spawned alien, I feel like.
A lot of people think that.
And I feel that the aliens have been trading technology with the government. I feel like for sure, because if you look how fast everything expanded, you know what I mean, within 60 years.
That's why I say that. I don't think the aliens even fucking with the government. But
they know about.
But I think that. I think that a certain small group of individuals that have a certain amount of money have access and technology and knowledge that we don't know. That's why I think.
Do you know about the Nazis?
The tall whites with the Nazis. I'm fucking on it, bro. That shit's crazy, and I believe
it. Tell me about the Nazis, dude.
The Nazis were building UFOs because an alien race came to them and gave them
this
technology.
They're called the tall whites. We've been talking about it in the studio all week. Everyone's looking at me like I'm nuts.
Bro, tell me about the tall whites, dude.
So the tall whites helped them develop weapons and technology, bro, and they were on a hype to take over the world, man. This shit's weird, bro. Like
the Aryans.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, then what happened? Did somebody stop him?
So when the shit went wrong,
America was like, "Fuck that! We're gonna go join this fucking war and do what we got to do and shut this shit down."
You gotta be bigger than what Americans said. If these guys were aliens, they gave aliens technology.
Well, yeah, I'm giving you the Hollywood.
How could Americans do anything?
Here's the crazy thing, though. Now they just admitted that they have hella footage. There's 30 million pages of unclassified information. That's a Gary Payton. It's power. Power.
This is dope.
Picture smoking this and reading about aliens for 5 minutes. But yeah, man, there's all the evidence in the world now that they're admitting that there is them, that there is aliens. And
dude.
Here's the trippy part, though.
So what did the aliens want?
They want to make sure we don't destroy each other with nuclear weapons. Because every time they're seen, it's by a nuclear base. When it went down in Roswell, they just did a nuclear test the day before. And so they're like, man, you motherfuckers are crazy, greedy. You're about to fuck the world up. That's what I think, man. I'm trying to get a hold of them.
Yeah, for sure. The aliens?
I want to.
Yeah.
Man. I want to know what's up.
Weedmaps is your guide to cannabis. And we make it easy for you to order weed online. In just a few clicks, you'll be well on your way to getting the good stuff. Connect with retailers nearby and search local brands for products you love and your new soon-to-be favorites. Visit weedmaps.com/orders and put your next smile in motion. Weedmaps. Learn about, find, and enjoy cannabis. Smartly.
You know about Bob Lazar?
Nah.
Talk to us about him.
Bob Lazar is this, aerospace engineer who, back in the early 90s, late 80s, early 90s, maybe even late 70s, early 80s, can't remember, he came out on the Las Vegas news talking about how there's a super secret base miles from Area 51.
Absolutely, Area 54, yeah.
Area 54, where there's this lake.
Mm-hmm.
You know the lake? What's the name of the lake?
I don't know.
There's a lake out there where there's a super secret base where they, this government agency, these agents brought him there blindfolded and put him in front of a UFO, an anti-gravity spacecraft. And they were like, we need you to reverse engineer this and figure out how this thing works and what this anti-gravity shit's all about.
I mean, Snowden, the dude that got caught from the...
Yeah.
He admitted that there's a hella alien shit going on. If you Google it, it's crazy.
Really?
Yeah, he lifted.
Just Google it. Google it! Yeah. Google!
And I'm telling you, Google's a motherfucker, bro.
I feel that in my fucking soul, Mike. Jesus Christ.
Yeah, he wants to know what's up. Snowden. I'm sorry. Snowden, bro. He's you know, he's definitely tripping off it right now, bro, for sure.
He's going to die soon. Snowden brought to light that the CIA was spying
yeah,
on
him. Yeah, no. I mean, he brought that to light. But here's another thing that if you want to get trippy. Snowden's in Russia being protected.
Right.
And there's some little weird conspiracies about the knowledge he has that he stole about the aliens and what Russia could do with that knowledge, man. So it's how deep you want to go into it, man.
Tall white space aliens control America.
I mean, that's fucked up. This might be true, man.
Hello.
Hello.
That's in Forbes, guys.
That's in Forbes
that's
magazine.
That's in fucking Forbes.
Yeah, that's not like...
That's not like weird alien today.
Yeah.
You know? That's fucking Forbes magazine.
Leaked by NSA whistleblower Edward Snowden. Shout out to Snowden, bro. I hope you stay safe, brother, because you are playing with a major game right now, bro. These motherfuckers are going to try to kill you, boy. You better be cool. You guys got to get Snowden on the podcast live from Russia.
Get Snowden on the pod. Fuck.
Dude, that'd be epic, bro. I need to know what he knows, man.
Get Snowden on the pod. Mike, what do you think about... See, look at this, brother. Edward Snowden conclusively proved that the United States has been ruled by a race of tall, white, space aliens who also assisted the rise of Nazi Germany in the 1930s.
There's a lot of proof that that could be true.
Well, you know,
so
all the...
told about people with a bunch of white races.
You know about Project... you know about Project Paperclip?
Like, it's kind of scary if you think about it. Nah. Yeah.
Project Paperclip.
Mm-mm. The Bohemian Grove, all this shit trips me out.
Project Paperclip, after World War II, America brought all the highest Nazi scientists and people over to work in America.
Oh, wow.
I don't know about that. That's too much conspiracy shit for
me. Dude, it's released.
Now, here's what they said, though.
It's out there. It's public domain.
They said that one of the captains in Hitler's army disappeared, and no one could figure out where he went.
Which one?
I forgot his name, but they said that that machine that they were developing, the Bell, they said, look, that motherfucker's probably just an alien.
The Bell was the spacecraft.
They're saying that motherfucker's probably just an alien working with them.
Yeah. Do I got any Illuminati shit?
Look at this.
Yeah, Illuminati. I want to know what's up with the Illuminati. People ask me, Illuminati talk to you? I'm like, fuck no.
Put in Mike Tyson... down with the Illuminati motherfucker.
Look.
All right, Roswell.
Yeah, that's crazy.
Did the Nazis got their spaceship?
They had a fucking spaceship in the 30s,
bro. That's the Bell. This is another... Dude, this shit is real.
Here's what they said, too, though.
I mean...
When you seen the video that the New York Times just posted about the Navy jets that tracked aliens for a week.
Yeah.
And it just came out everywhere around the world. It's on MSNBC, CNN. The way they fly, they have... So Nikola Tesla invented free energy, right? Just based off the world and what it gives off or whatever. I'm not smart enough to understand it. But they said the reason why their spaceship was going left, right, against the winds, up and down, with no gas coming out, is because the bottom of it was like a fucking crazy turned-up solar power just fucking vibes off the energy that the world gives you. There doesn't need no gas or no nothing like that.
All right. Some bullshit going down, man.
We just need to figure out how to get in touch with them so we can see what they smoking on, man. Period.
This is really well, you know about
that's that Gary Payton, man. Shout out to GP, man.
Gary Payton, the glove. We love you, brother.
Man. Shout
your
out.
Boss.
I got the glove GP. On your chronic right now.
Straight up, huh?
Well, you know where some people, the mythology behind where cannabis comes from. I'm about to blow your fucking mind.
Please do. I'm a tripper, dude. Let me trip out a little bit.
So, there's this tribe in West Africa called the Dogon tribe.
Mm-hmm.
And they have a year-long cannabis festival.
Mm-hmm.
And they have all these cave paintings of a time, an ancient time where beings from another, from the star.
I knew it. I knew it.
From the Sirius star.
I knew it.
Gave Sirius, us some cannabis.
Sirius A and B, the dog monk. Star. The two dog stars. This race came down from there, brought us cannabis, the two
it.
Dog plant. To bring us peace.
Man, look, let me tell you something.
Let's put it in there. Where cannabis come from?
I honestly believe that shit, bro, because this shit does unite all people. I've been in parties with different gangs who were not feeling each other, and I fired up some of this kind of shit, and motherfuckers was like vibing over that joint and the style of weed, and man, that shit does bring peace. And I believe the aliens created it too. Oh, shit.
Did aliens bring cannabis from Sirius B? The Dogon tribe, the origin of cannabis.
Osiris and shit?
Are you serious?
What are you talking about?
Take a look at the word cannabis. Ever wonder what it means? Cannabis is a Greek word, though its root is African. In Greek, canna means canine or dog, and bis or bi is the number two.
Cannabis to dog too?
So cannabis is the two dog plant.
Two dog plant, right?
I smoked some shit from Africa when I was in Amsterdam, and this dude brought by a bunch of weed. He had hella shit that looked like this, hella crisply, smelly. He said, if you want to smoke the best one, it's this land race shit, whatever he had. Yeah. And it was the ugliest looking weed. And I, as a joke, I rolled it up, and I hit that shit. And before my show, I literally asked my assistant and my boy if I was dying. My heart was beating so hard. That shit was strong as fuck.
Wow.
Strong. It was ugly. It didn't look good. And it was from that motherfucking shit over there, that lineage of strain. Man, they probably did bring it there. I believe it.
Yeah, dude.
I need to go get some seeds out there ASAP.
In Africa?
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, how about those guys, the strain Arjan?
That's my big brother. We're doing a breeding project with him right now. He wants me to come down to the Congo and do some work with him, but they're doing amazing things over there.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, it seems like it, man.
Yeah.
Weedmaps is your guide to cannabis. Do you have a favorite strain? Do you see strains at retailers and wonder what they are? How do you pick the best one? Learn about top reported effects, like getting creative or relaxed, and flavors like citrus or skunk for hundreds of strains. Visit weedmaps.com/strains and grow your weed knowledge today. Weedmaps. Learn about, find, and enjoy cannabis smartly.
We blasted off, and I'm just like trying to catch up.
We're eating this shit, man.
It's this shit.
Dude, check this shit out, okay?
Dog star.
Let me see where I want to read from.
Do you think it's weird that the government finally admitted that there's UFOs and that they don't know where they're from and that they've had encounters with? I mean, it's like, after all this time, because they had a whole program where they debunked it, where anyone that said something, they make them seem like a fucking idiot on air, and it's all a joke. But now that they're admitting it, like, that shit kind of, it's like a different time in the world now. And there's an article that just came out that said by 2050 we could all be extinct by the rate of climate change.
Yeah.
You seen that?
Yeah. All this shit is coming out. Cannabis, the psychedelics, all that shit is emerging into our awareness we got to fucking wake up.
Yeah, they just legalized shrooms in Oakland.
Yeah,
I
heard.
Yeah. I know. Wasn't that interesting?
Like, I want to go to Oakland and get high.
Come after on. Denver?
I got an office in Oakland. We can get high out there and go to the office and vibe out.
But so decriminalized, it's just...
So what's that mean? Like, if I get pulled over in Oakland with some shrooms, I'm good? It,
you're fine.
Yeah.
I guess so. But I don't think that... Because there's a lot of controversy over, you know, does that make them legal? Can you still grow them? And
Bay, when we get a gray area, we're going to trap or die. Yeah, so we're going to use that it's legal all the way to the fucking end.
Yeah.
It's all good. It's legal. Google it.
Yeah. So.
For sure.
What else is going on in your world? What's new?
Man, just expanding cookies as a brand and building my other partners' brands like Grand DeFlore and shit. Making music, trying to live this life. Vibes Papers. These are new, you know. This is my paper company. And, you know, there's only one big guy in the paper industry, so there's been some beef, you know. Motherfuckers feel threatened by your boy Berner because I move mean, I work hard. But these are starting to cause a lot of, you know, talk, you know.
I like them.
They're good, man. They smell good.
Yeah, fuck yeah.
And there's good vibes behind them, too. You know what I mean? These were curated for the connoisseur, man, for what we're smoking on right now. That's how we made our papers. That Gary, bro, my boy been blowing on that, man. Let me touch that, man.
I get carried away sometimes.
No, I love it. That's how you know it's good. He was blowing on that motherfucker, bro.
It is good, isn't it?
Yeah.
I'm going to leave the rest of this with you then.
It's herby.
Good. Yeah, man.
It's got some fucking some ancient herb essence this going some, this on. This some in funk, that shit,
like
dude.
The shit we smoked at first was like an appetizer. Tastes really, really good.
Yeah,
but this shit will knock you.
Yeah, that's like some fucking grown man weed right there.
Some boss weed.
Yeah, it's fucking good, man. I appreciate everything you do, man.
Appreciate you guys.
Big time.
I'm excited about the collab, too. The fact that we got you guys' herb in the stores. We're going to blow that shit out.
Appreciate it.
There's a lot of stuff.
It's going to be international shit, nigga. You can have a cookie. You can have you could showcase it there.
Oh, we're going to pop it off. We're going to do a taste test over there. I'm going to talk to the boys when we get out of here and see how we can run it for a private event for all the bud tenders in California to come out to the Tyson Ranch with Burn, with Tyson, to smoke all the new flavors and let them
eat. And mushrooms, too.
Ooh.
I love that.
Yeah, we're going to definitely be in good standings with everyone if we do shrooms with them. It's going to be a wrap. It's going to be all good memories.
Excellent.
Except for a few that don't know.
Oh, no.
You do shrooms, Mike?
Yeah.
You like them?
I can't live without them.
Really?
Big time.
I would fucking shroom with you, dude. I really would, bro. I would. I ain't gonna lie, now that I'm an OG, I'm a little older and I'm more paranoid because I might be rich one day. I'm like scared to do drugs, but I'd shroom with him for sure, dude. It'd probably be the best shit ever, dude. For sure.
Mike?
Fuck yeah.
Mike's a shaman, dude.
Awesome. Dude, he's definitely a shaman, bro, for sure.
Yeah. That's what we do here.
Yeah.
It's good stuff. Well, thanks, brother.
Appreciate you guys having me, man. For real, bro. You. I got some of these out the jar. I'm gonna leave y'all too.
Awesome. Appreciate Thank that, brother. You. We're high.
Yes, we are.
We high as giraffe pussy, nigga.
Yes, that's extra high.
In the hot box.
Mike, great episode, brother.
I think so as well.
People gotta wake up on the aliens, man. For real.
A lot of fun. Wake the fuck up.
Yeah, man.
Read a book.
Get off fucking Instagram.
Listen, as big as this universe is and these galaxies, you really believe we're the only fucking sophisticated civilization out here?
That's just ignorant.
I believe at one time the civilization, the other planets near us, I believe they exist at one time and it's burnt out.
Yeah.
We're gonna do one day.
Yeah.
It's burnt out.
That's right.
Hey, we're going to be burning when we get burnt out, though, man. Bottom line.
Yeah, that's what you got to do. Won't feel a thing.
But you know what?
Cannabis will be there to get us through.
Here's a big conspiracy before we get out, man. If aliens brought weed to Earth and we're ambassadors of weed here on Earth, man, maybe they'll keep us around, man.
Yeah. I think they want to help us. I think they're like, yo, you guys have it by the fucking balls.
Mm-hmm. I wish I knew who we were, man.
Don't fuck this up, guys. You know?
Don't fuck it up.
Don't fuck it up.
Don't be like the Romans.
Here's another thought for you.
The Romans.
Here's a thought for you.
And the Africans.
What if the aliens are actually just us from a future dimension who have evolved into this new race that communicates telepathically?
We're
coming back to our younger selves to say, stop fucking this up.
I don't know. I just think when it's over, it's over. But
it's over. It's over. Yes.
No.
I think the same thing is fucked up, Mike. Dude.
I think it's over. It's over. No, I'm talking
about
for
here.
For here, this world.
For this world.
For this world, it's over.
I wonder where my soul is going to go, though? Because I got a lot of soul. Is it just turn off?
No, you're going to be there.
Is it just gone?
No, you're going to be there.
I really get really, really worried about this. I'm like, am I just going to go?
Not you, but yeah, you will be there.
Yeah, I hope so.
Yeah.
I'll be a dog in my next life.
We'll be smoking one again in the next life.
Fuck yeah.
Oh, man. God willing.
All right, y'all. Well, hey, everybody. Be sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel, Hotboxin with Mike Tyson. Check us out on social media, on Spotify, Instagram, Twitter. Follow Mike. Follow Hotboxin Podcast. Follow Berner. Berner, what's
tell
your...
Tell the people
tell them where they can
where
find
you,
brother.
Find you,
oh, man, just go on Instagram or Twitter. It's Berner415, Berner with an E. You'll find your boy. Just put in Berner.
Berner415.
Cookies, man, cookies.
Cookies.
Cookie.
Check us out, y'all. We love you guys. Thanks for listening. Thanks for watching. Until next time. Peace.
I definitely stream with Mike, dude. I probably have a really good trip with you, bro, for sure.